Hello and welcome to the show. My name is Chris, and this is a rant on season 3, episode 4 of The Last of Us. So it's roughly 11 o'clock at night. I just got done watching this with my buddy Ahmed, or Zaz, whatever you want to call him. Just catch us on the Average Joe's Reacts channel. And I like this episode. Kind of, sort of. I'm pretty sure when I was talking to Ahmed, in my head I liked it more than I thought I did. But there were good bits of, in this episode, I think. We get to see Joel for what Joel probably is in the video game, from what I understand. You know, like, we've been told kind of how scary he is by the people that were beating up Tess in episode 1. You know, it's like implied that he's this dude that's just gonna wreck shop. In this scene right here, you see Ellie. She for the first time, I think, truly saw what Joel is capable of. You can't really, I'm trying to squint on the screen that I'm going to be recording on, but you can see a tear. Like, I know some of that's because she probably shot the dude and he was talking back to her, which probably has never happened to her. But the way in which Joel was like, get out of here, go now. Like, she knew what was about to happen. And we get to figure out kind of what Joel's about to do to this cat. But in this episode, you kind of start with them in a gas station. It's like every gas station has like a damn room that she could sneak into that's not the bathroom. And it feels like everyone, the ones in so far in the show, have had some kind of like underground bunker. And she, you know, she sneaks into this room. She kind of sneaks into this room and is playing with a gun. Maybe it's a bathroom. I don't know. I thought it just kind of looked like another underground bunker, like the first time that we saw them in a gas station. But they're filling up the truck. You know, they're talking about some of the things you used to be able to do with a vehicle. They're kind of establishing the bond between these two. And then they go driving and they stop. Because it's getting dark and they stop in the woods, which I don't know if I would. I feel like I would try finding like a house or a barn or something that you could park a vehicle in and hide for the night. But parking in the woods with, again, basically no protection, things that can kill you, like, I don't know, bears and wolves and whatever else is in the woods, minus the infected, minus people walking around. You're just kind of campfire in the woods, open, you know, like nothing's gonna be curious and come kill you. You don't sleep in the truck, which would probably be safer, you know, because you could lock the doors and more sleep in the bed of the truck. But they sleep on the ground. I just found it kind of weird. The kind of like dad jokes, the pun jokes or whatever that go back and forth between them, I thought was pretty good, you know, bonding and establishing character moments, character growth. They're growing together in, you know, like the theme of this whole TV series. And after episode 3, this just felt so much better, because it felt like we're back to who the story's supposed to focus on, you know. But they end up driving. I swear to God, he mentioned something about 76. And like 70 or 71 or something like that. And that's like my neck of the woods area. So he goes from, hey, you know, just this little road here and this connects to that road, to, hey, take a nap. And next thing you know, they're in Kansas City. Really? That's like 4 states. talking at least on a good day, 12-hour drive. She doesn't wake up one time. Doesn't have the urge to pee. Maybe they stopped and didn't show that. But it's just... it's kind of a weird cutscene. That you go, hey, stop looking at that and go to sleep. And then next thing you know, you're in Kansas City. Dude, they were in PA. They were in PA. They were in Western PA. But again, you got to go through at least Ohio, Kentucky, and what, Missouri, I think it is, before you get to Kansas City. It's one of those states like above Mississippi, but like Kansas City is on the other side of the river, if I remember right. If I remember my geography, like that's a long drive. I've done Northeast Ohio to like Western Kentucky. That's a drive. It's kind of a flaw with me. I don't like it. I didn't like that cutscene. It's just kind of weird. But then we get in this battle with them fighting. So they get into this little battle scene after being ambushed, and I saw that coming a mile away. So Joel should have too. And you see Joel fighting him off, and again, it's kind of, from what I understand, again, total noob, I've never played the game, but from what I understand, Joel's pretty tough, resourceful, badass guy. So seeing that from him was, I think, kind of nice for me. It showed what we could be getting from the series, I guess you could say. And, you know, the intelligence he had to be able to, you know, figure out where people were shooting from and fire back to get them out of the situation, that was pretty shitty. And then we go to this, I'm going to call it a B-plot in this episode. And it's just this militia that took over Fedra in St. Louis. And I have problems with that kind of thinking in a world where the apocalypse did happen, where you're limited with people. Because so she organized, or someone organized, a rebellion. And I've watched 4 and 5, so I know who. But in this, I don't remember them specifically saying who organized it. I just assumed her. And he, or she, like, she more or less is killing people if they were collaborators. So you can't redeem someone because they were doing what they had to do to survive. Yeah, it's kind of shitty turning your back on your fellow, you know, human, and turning them in for something that the government says isn't good. But like, in this world, we don't have, this is supposed to be basically 2003, circa America, 2003, right? Like, that's when the shit kicked off. And we didn't have the kind of division that I don't think you would see in this kind of world. So I don't buy the B plot in this episode in the way they laid it out. But just like, she's just this woman boss is going around basically murdering whoever they assume is a collaborator, or that just isn't giving people chances, and she's just killing off chunks of the population. Again, you are trying to survive. There has to be a better way. Has to be a better way than just killing off mass groups of people because they didn't agree with your fight. I guess is the best way I could put it. I didn't like that plot line. I could have literally cared less about anything that happened with her other than she's a complete psycho. And I, quite frankly, in the, I don't know, hour and a half since I've watched that show, I forgot I don't care. I don't care about her storyline. It doesn't make sense to me. I don't agree with it. But, you know, Joel and Ellie kind of sneak throughout the city, and they end off the episode with the girl boss and her second lieutenant, who is trying to give her sound advice. We need to tell the people what is going on about this, like, sinkhole, which, just because of the show, I'm assuming is some kind of, in this moment, I'm assuming is some kind of fungus growth or something like that, right? Some kind of something that's going to cause some kind of infected issue. And we this is two episodes in a row you don't see infected, except for one quick shot in episode 3. You just don't see him. I didn't agree with this B plot. There could have been a better way. I don't know how. But you see kind of a little growth between Joel and Ellie. She's still a little snot-nosed brat, but she's kind of, I'm not going to say she's calming down, she's getting better, but she's kind of coming around to the idea of Joel protecting her, and you could see Joel kind of coming around to the idea of protecting her. So there is that kind of growth. You know, other than that one scene with Joel where he, like, kills a boy that she shot, you don't see any real growth that I've noticed. Maybe there is, and if you want to, you know, disagree with me, comment section below, or find me on Discord. I think that's gonna end this rant. I gave it I want to say like a 7 when I was talking to Ahmed after the show, but like, other than that one scene where they're fighting, you know, it's just a lot of sneaking around. Oh, here's your gun, you can have it back, and make sure you keep it on safe. Like, basic shit she should have been taught by now, being with Joel. And I don't know why it took this long. And for them to be in that shit of a situation, for him to go, you know what, there's two of us here, maybe you should have a gun. You know, just in case. So, just in case I'm pinned down or shot, or I run out of ammo, you should have something to back me up with. But, like, it's just, I feel like we're 4 episodes in, and we barely really know what's going on. Like, I still can't figure out a theme other than I know what's supposed to happen. Like, is the theme of this whole show just get Ellie to said group of people? Is that what it is? In each episode's like part of the plot where, hey, you know, we're fighting through parts of the country. Like, you got a truck. Avoid a big fucking city. Like, why are you trying to go right through Kansas City? You obviously have a map of the USA. You can see roads. It's stupid. There's stupid, stupid bits to this story that could be avoided. All right. With that said, I think I'm going to end this little rant, my little thoughts. If you guys want to, like I said again, if you want to have discourse, find me on Discord, comment section below. And if you liked what you saw, or if you didn't, you know, like, share, subscribe, disagree, dislike. It's up to you. Till next time. Bye-bye.